Hey, 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 what's going on? It's the King Kevin Show. Thanks for tuning in today, January 8th, 2014. Yes, yes. So, today we're going to talk about the blessings of God and the power of believing in God. You know, there's many blessings in that, and I hope that you all started this year on the right foot. It's vitally important that you do, because if you don't, then you're on the opposite side of the right foot, which means that, you know, you can start everything with balance. You know, you want to make sure that you're spiritually grounded, you make sure that your finances are in order, or at least you're planning for them to be in order, because, you know, we all make mistakes. You have a good strategy, good plan, and all that good stuff. Of course, you're on the King Kevin Show. I'm Kevin Dorval. That's what my flyer says. But before I start the show, definitely big shout out to the MLKCC and, you know, for everything they're doing, the Martin Luther King Celebration Committee. I just came from the meeting. That's why today the show is starting at 7:20, actually 7:27, instead of 7 o'clock. But I did post it's going to be at 7:20. So if you didn't, or you wasn't paying attention to me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff, then get to it. It's Courage. Number two, believe, all right? This is a flyer that we got going on, the big poster, MLK Day. We have many great events. I'm going to post this on my website, or at least on my Facebook. So we are in charge, actually, of hosting the big parade here in South Florida. Actually, I believe it's the biggest parade in Florida, and we're in charge of it. I've been part of the organization for 5 years. I've been an advocate for success, definitely, but empowering my community, inspiring my community, and this organization was the only one that I seen doing something, and I'm glad to be part of it. But let's get to it, shall we? Now, the song that you guys were just listening to is by Norman Hutchins. He's actually follows me on Twitter, and he has a song, God's Got a Blessing, with your name on it. This song, it inspires me every day. I mean, every day I listen to it, it encourages me to just, you know, imagine everything that I want in life, which is powerful when you can actually think about something and to go from your head into reality. You know, a lot of people have great ideas. You know, most of us have great ideas. You know, I've had many great ideas in my life. This show was one of them. Actually, that was God's idea, because I was fighting for a while. I didn't want to do it. But then finally, I was like, man, let's go ahead and run it. And at the time, I really didn't have the money to get everything started. But I did it anyway, because if you wait for everything to be perfect, you're not going to do anything at all. But this song is playing, so check it out. I'm going to be right back to you. So don't go anywhere. This is the song. Grabbing my Bible right here.
For your blessings, get ready. Get ready. For your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
I told y'all I was going to be back. Hopefully this song isn't too loud over my voice, but that's something that we've been challenged with the past couple of shows, getting the technical difficulties going with the show and everything. I can see why these big major networks, which one day they're going to buy my show from me, want me to host it on CNN, ABC, ESPN, who knows? But on a serious tip, I do believe in the power of words. I'm a true believer of it. I've been a proponent of that since like day one. I've always, ever since as a grown adult, believed that my words will dictate where I go tonight. Now, for some of you, if you're always talking about negativity, you're cursing around others, you know, cursing yourself at the same time, think about that. You know, my pastor Ed, he taught us at Redeeming Word Christian Center. So shout out to Pastor Ed, Pastor Ed, if you're watching. Back in the day, in ancient history, you know, biblical times, when people were going to war, they would stand on opposing sides, could be, you know, one part of the valley or across the river, whatever the case may be, and they will speak curses to the other side. You know, may you and your family not go forward. May you stay in the same place year after year. May you not be successful. May your daughters not have kids. Your son will get married. You know, all kinds of foolishness. Those were cursed. They were cursing each other, cursed words. And when I got the revelation of that, I was like, okay, cursed words. I have a problem with the person. So let me stop that. Let me see if I can, instead of speaking curses, speak blessings. And that's when things started to change. Now, it took me a year, maybe a year and a half, to slowly dissolve the whole cursing epidemic. But that wouldn't have happened if I didn't get it, if God didn't convict me of it. So those of you who are cursing yourself, and those that you speak to, that's why people speak to me. And they are prolific curses. I excuse myself, or I ask them today, you know, saying, you know, cut that out. Not because I'm all holier than thou, it's because I respect my mind and my spirit. Of course, my body. The Trinity. So, definitely call in the show, 305-600-5916. I love to hear your testimonies. I love to hear how God has been good to you in 2014 or in 2013, and how it's going to be expounded upon in 2014. All right? People need to be encouraged. You know, this is what life is about, encouraging each other. I was just listening to a Joel Osteen video earlier, and he was saying how you have certain people in your life. Some people are there to drag you down. You have other people who are there to thrust you to another level. I like to be around people who are going to thrust me to another level, people who are going to prepare me to another level. And that is what I speak upon every time I'm on a microphone, every time, whether it's on the show or if I'm at a speaking engagement or amongst my friends. I am always speaking about moving forward. I refuse to be around people that are not about moving forward. But that's what the power of God is. Moving forward. That's powerful. That's power. And I believe that one of the reasons why many of us, we lack power, is because we are not acknowledging the lack that we have in our life. And the longer you keep ignoring the lack you have in your life and not addressing it, you're going to lack power. Now, the definition of power, just to make this clear to everyone, the ability to do something or act in a particular way as a quality. It could be a quality as well. That you know, power is quality. But to be able to speak, to be able to act regardless of the opposition, to do what you plan on doing anyway, that's powerful. Now, there's other words for power, other synonyms and things like that. And then you've got some synonyms. I think it's vitally important that, you know, when you're reading a word, understand what are the opposites of that word. What other words are similar to it, okay? The power of speech, ability, capacity, potential, faculty, competence. You know, those are some other words for power. Now, for a long time, I ain't have no power. I was broke, and not just broke financially, I was broke spiritually as well. And when you have both those things going against you, you are a poor individual, literally. You're not going to go anywhere, and you're going to continue being in that same position if you don't address that problem. Now, how do you obtain those blessings of God, the power of God, so that you can move forward in life, so that you can make things happen? Because at the end of the day, that's all we all want, that, right? We want to be able to move forward. You don't want to be going to school and don't graduate. You don't want to be dating an individual, a woman or a female, and actually be in love with them and want to have kids with them and not do so. You don't want to start a business and not have revenue coming in. It is power to actually claim those things that are not as if they were. You know, that's Hebrews 11:1, if I'm not mistaken. I don't have my Bible open. Actually, I do have my Bible open, but not in that scripture. Now, I may not completely agree with everything in the King James Bible. And I said King James Bible for a reason. because this Bible is written by a king that happened to be a homosexual. A lot of people don't know that. However, the origins of the Bible, the power within the Bible, and the scriptures, the stories, majority of them come from Africa, from ancient Africa. And King James actually took it. He seen the power of it. He took it and had someone, supposedly Shakespeare, but he had some creative writer take all the stories and create the King James Bible from it. Now, there's other Bibles, but this isn't the original one. Now, I don't want that to deter anybody. Oh, that's of the devil. No, I'm telling you historical facts. There's a difference between mythological facts and historical facts. So you got to be careful, you know, when you're using that word, you know, was factual and what you just believe in, because that what you was told, that what you were preached to all your life, your mom, your grandma, your great grandmother, your great 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 grandfather, and things of that nature. So, but the power within the Bible, and also books as well. That's how I became King Kevin. Because I was able to read, I was able to write, and apply the knowledge that I got from my studies. I applied them. That's what you should do when you're reading books. I wouldn't just be reading books just to be reading it. I'd be reading a book that's going to be applicable to my life so I can be successful. So I can change the course of my family. Because my family, for many years, they have no power. For many years, my family struggled every day. Every day, hand to mouth, every day. That's not what it's about. God wants us to reap the blessings that he has here on earth, from heaven to earth. There's a pastor Brazelton. He actually came to visit my church, Redeeming Word, and he said something that was very profound. He said, in order for you to live a life of bountifulness, you need to live as if heaven's currency on earth. And you can't do that without faith. And faith is what took me literally to another level. Once I started believing in myself, once I started hanging around other believers, other eagles. Now, eagles fly high. When you're able to fly high, you can look down and have a better view of the world, better view of the situations in life. And that's what many of us, we don't have. But we can get it. God has everything in front of us. So, most of the time, everything we want in life is right in front of you. Everything. There's nothing missing. All you got to do is reach for it and believe it. And God is going to provide it. Right now, I'm playing a song by CeeDee High called Caramel. It's an old song back in the 90s. I found it early on YouTube. I just had to play it. Produced by Wyclef Jean. He produced them. They were doing their thing for, you know, a good bit. But yeah, a little soundtrack for you guys. Now, let's get back to what I was saying. And I hope this isn't too loud, as I mentioned. It is quite important. Stop letting people steal your joy and wasting your time and energy. Nobody have time for that. And you don't either. There's many friends that we might have had, many family members we grew up with, and they're nothing but blockers. They're blocking you from your blessings. I'm telling you. I let go of so many of my friends over the years. And some of them, they just didn't know who they were. So they ended up making consistent bad decisions on a regular basis, day by day. Now they're in prison. Some of them doing life. Life's about loving, sharing, prospering, caring, married with kids, successful business, successful career, being able to break bread, and being able to encourage other people. When you get to that level, now you are a man or woman of power. Now you live in the blessings of the Lord. Not you have to have like a S550 Mercedes-Benz, which is a beautiful car by the way. That may be powerful in the physical realm because people see that, like, wow, you're doing something right. You know, whether legal or illegal, you're doing something. Now you're able to allocate the amount of money to get that kind of car or trick somebody to let you hold it. No, that's power. I want this show to be about power. And You also should have tested. Don't forget to call me. And may the blessings of the Lord make you rich as a son. That's one scripture I always say properly every day of my life. I'll never stop saying that. The day I do stop saying that, you know something is wrong. Now, I don't know how many of you guys watched that FSU game the other night. That was powerful. You know, that quarterback, you know, number 5, man, he was doing his thing. What's his name? Jamie? And then the defense did their thing. That was power right there. They did not give up. They kept believing themselves, and they kept going for it. They believed that they was going to win, and they continued to push forward. And guess what? They came back 18-point deficit, and they won. They actually, you know, they did a great job, and I love that game. The country loved the game, and I wonder how many people was inspired by it. You know I definitely was, and I hope you were too, and that you learned a lesson from it. This guy, 19 years old, I believe he was 19, but anyway, he's a freshman, went in. Freshman in college, got the Heisman Trophy Award, went in national championship, and it's his birthday, all at the same time. You know, if that's not a blessing of the Lord, I don't know what is. So I just hope that you guys actually learn something, not just so that you can keep it to yourself, but share it with other people. I might say something that, you know, that you love. You know, I may say something that's going to inspire you, to encourage you, that fire in your spirit to go ahead after your dreams and goals, no matter what. That's what I call my book, Courage to Believe. And on the front cover, like I always say, it says, never give up, keep moving forward. And I just want you guys to take heed to that and be encouraged, man. Be encouraged. I don't care if you're trying to get this new job. When you go to an interview, I want you to approach that interview as if, don't say I'm going to an interview. Say I'm going to my new job. That's the blessings of the Lord. Instead of saying or agreeing to what your finances are saying in the bank, be like, man, thank God I got these few thousands up in here. Thank God I'm able to go buy this new house. You keep speaking until you believe it. Because you know why you're going to start believing? It's because you're going to notice as you keep talking, as you keep speaking those things, that eventually the universe is going to come in agreement with you. You know, you put that energy out there, the universe, it's going to. So think about it as stars. Each time you keep speaking your dreams, you got one star popping up. Bing! Another star popping. Bing! Another star pop up. Bing! Keep speaking every day. And each star that happens, you're able to step on those stars and keep walking up that ladder. You know what I mean? Keep walking towards you. Walking towards that. You're pulling your future to you. And that's what power is. Okay? I can't stress that enough. Now, we're going to go ahead and hit a scripture. I don't know if you guys got a Bible on you or not. But be sure to constantly declare Satan's defeat. That's what Pastor Maldonado said at our leadership conference not too long ago. He said, constantly declare Satan's defeat every day. And when you do that, when you declare his defeat, he's destroyed. All right? He's defeated, annihilated, eliminated. You know what I mean? Keep speaking his defeat. Don't magnify that issue that you got going on. And that's one thing I had to catch myself with. Because a lot of times people would keep speaking about this problem that occurred, which is cool. But then when you keep magnifying that, you keep giving that thing power, now you're pushing God out. You know what I'm saying? You're not giving the Lord any room because you're not giving the Lord no kind of credit. And that's not what it's about. It's about continuing praising God no matter what. No matter what. Continue giving God thanks. Continue giving God the glory in advance. All right? Now, Numbers 23:19. I want you guys to go to that scripture, because actually, when I was in church the other day, this was something that my pastor spoke about. Now, as I find this, and if you guys don't know, Numbers 23:19 is in the beginning of the book, you know, beginning of the Bible, right after Exodus, which is after Genesis, for those of you who don't know, okay? I happen to know this because I was in my Bible earlier. I'm kidding about that. I know where Numbers is. So, Numbers 23:19, and here we are. God is not a man, so he does not lie. He is not human, so he does not change his mind. Has he spoken or failed to act? Has he ever promised and not carried it through? Listen, I received a command to bless. God has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. No misfortune is in his plan for Jacob. No trouble is in store for Israel. For the Lord, their God, is with them. He has been proclaimed their king. God brought them out of Egypt. For them, he is as strong as a wild ox. No curse can touch Jacob. Now, Jacob and Israel represents us, the children of God. And I just said it, he has blessed you, and God is with them, with us. Now, when you walk around every day, don't walk around with your head down. Walk around with your head up. Walk around as if you, not even as if, walk around and you know God is with you. Walk around, you know you're going to get the job. You know you're going to get this career. You know you're going to buy this house. You know this car is going to be paid for. And by the way, I'm going to throw a party when my car is paid for. And let me tell you guys something about this. I'll tell you guys some other time, because it doesn't go along with the show, about what happened to me today regarding my car and at the mechanic shop. But I'm going to share a testimony with you guys, which is a very true testimony. Now, when I realized that God was with me, it actually happened when I was going through a very, very troubling time. I mean, it was so troubling that I couldn't sleep, I couldn't eat. And it was so bad that my family couldn't sleep or eat, my close family. And only one friend knew about the situation, actually two friends knew about it, outside of my family. And I really didn't know what to do, where to go. And all my mom was just saying, was just, you know, Kevin, just pray and read the Bible. None of my friends could give me any advice, because none of them have never been in a situation, and I hope no one ever does. But I easily could be behind those prison walls right now. But by the grace of God, I'm here today. January 8th, 2014, doing the King Kevin Show. And that is why, you know, I'm doing the show today, so I can encourage all of you to continue. To encourage all of you to have faith and to never give up and to keep moving forward. Because at the end of the day, in the beginning of the day, not just end of the day, to continue being blessed, continue being encouraged, continue having faith, and just never giving up, because it is so easy to just give up on our dreams and goals. And unfortunately, a lot of people just seem to quit. Just seem to quit when things seem tough, and when things seem harsh, when things seem impossible, we seem to give up. We seem to throw in the towel when we shouldn't even be doing that. Life isn't meant to be easy. I say that because, you know, sometimes we seem to be lazy with certain things or activities in our lives because we don't want to fight for it. I was just telling a friend earlier today that I believe in life, you sometimes have to go against the forces of nature. You have to sometimes battle for the things you want in life. That you got to show the Lord, you got to show God you want it that bad. Everything is pointing against you. Everything is pointing to you to stop, to quit, to give up. But I am a true believer that should not be so. I believe that we should never quit on the things that we believe in. We should never quit on what we truly believe is ours. Don't ever stop believing that you don't deserve the blessings of God, because we all do. We deserve the best in life. And that's what it's about. It's about being blessed so you can be a blessing to others. And that's the one thing I pray to God that I'm always, always doing. You know, I was at the McDonald's earlier today. You know, I seen a man. You could tell he was struggling. And when I seen the first time, I was going to the bathroom, washed my hands. And when I walked away and came back, I seen that, I took a closer look at him. I seen his clothes, and I seen that he had these bags around him. You know, he had all these bags, like his bag of clothes, bag of soda bottles, bags of a couple of books in it, bags of this, bags of that. And I went to go order my food. I should have asked him what did he want to eat so I could pay for it. But what I did instead, my spirit convicted me. It was like, turn back and, you know, be a blessing to him. You know, I wasn't told how to do it, whether it was to buy him a meal, which I probably should have done, just to make sure that he did get something to eat. But what I did was, I slid him, you know, a few bucks, and I also gave him some words of encouragement. And to find out, this man is very, very intelligent. He's telling me about his newspapers he read, and telling me about, and I gave him one of my flyers, you know, which you guys should have seen by now, but, you know, see it on my website. And he was telling me what newspapers around the country to send a press release to. You know, since I'm a mentor, I'm working on documentaries, which, by the way, we're going to be doing another online fundraiser. Fundraiser is ongoing right now. So go to my website, CourageToBelieve.com. I want to always say that. But he was telling me that with something like this, you know, it can go big. Man, you can do this. Man, you're going to touch so many lives. Like, he was encouraged. And I was telling him, like, look, I know right now the situation may not look all that good. I don't know you from campaign. His name was Jeffrey, by the way. And I shook his hand, literally shook his hand. Most people probably wouldn't have done something like that. But I told him, it doesn't matter what it looks like. You can still be prosperous. You can still go to school. You can still get that master's degree if that's what you desire. You can still get married or remarried or have kids. If you don't have any kids, you can still go and do that, but you have to believe it. I told him that. I can believe it all day and night, but if you don't believe it, it's not going to happen. And we parted ways, and I felt good. I felt as if I was the influence on him to believe in himself. I felt as if I was the influence to bless him, you know. And, you know, I was debating whether or not I would say this on a show, but I felt as if it needed to be said, because sometimes we just give people money and just, you know, be on your way. Or we don't give them anything. Just get out of here. Whether I would have gave him any money or just some words of encouragement, I knew I had to do something. And that's what life is about. Sometimes you just gotta do something. You know, you can't see somebody struggling. And that's also power as well. You're believing in God that, okay, I'm being a blessing to you with this. I know I'm gonna have much more coming, because God releases things out your life to make room for more. So the money I gave him, it's not that I'm expecting the Lord to bless me to replace that money. I already know I have a harvest coming regardless, because I have a revelation of who I am. Now, the question is, do you have a revelation of who you are? In life, you never know what's going to happen. You just have to believe that, trust in God, that what your spirit is leading you to. And best believe, it's not always good spirits talking to you. There are evil spirits as well. So you have to be able to have discernment. The spirit of discernment to determine whether this is God speaking to you or that's the enemy speaking to you. Because the enemy could have been speaking to me to go bless this man, so that knowing that this man could have just opened up a door of curses into my life. But I knew that was God. Because once I spoke to him, he blessed me with advice. He was an encouragement to me to continue to do what I was doing.
You know, so that's, you know, that was the moral of the story. I just want to make sure I shared that with you guys. And if you see someone homeless or struggling, I mean, believe that the few bucks you have, that God's going to bless you with 10, 20, 30 times. Excuse me, more than that. And I want you guys calling the show to share me some testimonies of how God has been good to you. And I'm going to go ahead and if you guys heard this song, Marek Brown Clark, It Ain't Over Till God Says It's Over. I absolutely love this song. This song has been such a blessing to me. I even wanted to have it played on my stage play, which was a year ago, which is today's like a year anniversary, actually. January 5th was year anniversary since I had my book signing and the stage play, which was absolutely phenomenal. I just thank God for everything, you know, and that's why I've been so successful, or why am I going to be a multimillionaire? It's because I have plans with that money. Build schools, build libraries, help build some churches, build infrastructure. You know, when you have a plan like that, God has to come behind you, because that's God's idea for you to be a blessing to many other people. And, wow. Amen, right? So, we can go ahead to the next scripture. You guys got your Bibles open. And this is something that many of us can relate to, which, you know, deals with having battles in life. You know, we all have battles. We all have wars to face. And believe me, for you, if you think that you're going to go around with life like it's a walk in the park, not going to have any struggles, no issues, everything is just perfect, somebody's lying to you. Because in life, you're going to have many challenges. That's just part of it. You're going to have wars. You're going to have fiery arrows shooting at you. You're going to have darts. You're going to have bullets. You're going to have, you know, people swinging swords and knives and curses at you. But you got to believe that you have the shield of righteousness and that God is going to protect you. Not because you're just saying it, but because you actually believe it. It's deeply rooted within you. Each and every one of us are gods. We are little gods compared to the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And when you walk around like that, believing that, it gives you confidence. It gives you boldness, you know. And for instance, when I was going through that situation, I was telling you guys when I was in college, and my friends didn't give me any advice. Believe me, it took boldness to go to class not knowing if the police is going to kick in the door any moment to come arrest me. And I wouldn't have done that if I didn't have the courage to believe in myself and my God-given abilities and knowing that God was with me. So believe that the Lord is with you every day. When you wake up in the morning, whoever you're speaking to in the morning, encourage them. That's important. That might be the only words of encouragement they get. When you walk out that door, believe that the Lord is with you. When you first step out, and you're going to do that because you're going to remind yourself with the prayer. Before I walk out the house, and I would never tell anybody to do anything that I don't do myself or that I haven't done. Before you walk out the house, speak the blessings of yourself and your family and friends. That is something that I cannot stress enough. It is vitally important to be a blessing to yourself and to your family. Now, all is good, all is great, and just believe that God got your back. Believe that God has your front. The purpose of the enemy is to get you to stop praising God. Because the moment you stop doing that, he knows you're going to magnify the kingdom of evil. Now, whether you guys believe in God and you're watching the show, I know you got to believe in God, or you're an atheist, or you believe in the devil, you just want to watch my show so you can hate on and critique it, which, you know, I could care less about. I wanted to encourage and empower as many people as possible. That's just my vision. It doesn't have to be yours. But it is important that you be mindful of the words that you speak. That they're words of gold and treasure, which I'll explain. And what I mean by words of gold and treasure is that when you speak to someone, that it's a gift. That you are blessing them with the gift of whether it's gift of life, the gift of courage, you know what I'm saying? You blessing them, or you bless them with prosperity. Those words that you speak, that's why it's important to pick the right queen. And by the way, we're going to do part two of the seven types of queens that kings desire on the 29th. Mrs. Mosley, the queen code, she's going to be on the show with me. So stay tuned for that, 7 p.m. sharp on the 29th. That's going to be an awesome show. And we're also going to do a special show of the book, Uncle Tom's Cabin, Black History. Well, I'm not even going to say that. In February, every day is Black History Day. You know, there is no Black History Month in my book. Or you can just, you know what I mean? There's no particular month. Every month is that. You know, I believe it's important to support your heritage and your culture. As a matter of fact, I've been carrying this banner on my hand for the past year. It says, I support my heritage. And I believe every culture should do that. And today, we are going to feature one of my favorite authors, Chancellor Williams, The Destruction of Black Civilization. This author published this book. This is a very old book, as a matter of fact. But this book tells you a lot about African history, but also European history and their influence in Africa. And I can't stress enough how much this book literally changed my life. I mean, Dr. Borishango says that we should read this book 10, 20, 30 times in our life, you know. And Chancellor Williams published this book back in 1987, Great Issues of Erase from 4500 BC to 2000 AD. If you don't have this book, definitely check it out. However, I'm going to grab my book right quick. I want you guys to go ahead and get the book on the Thomas Cabin. This book, I'm not even finished reading it, but by sometime in February, and I am going to promote it, so, you know, be sure to go to my website. We are going to feature Uncle Tom's Cabin, and the whole show is going to be about it. How, even though this is a book of the past, and the reason why, well, actually, it's not the reason why, but the reason why I love history is because it's nonfiction, it's real. I can apply it to my life. So I believe that if you don't take hold of what happened in the past and have a good understanding, a comprehension of it, you are bound to repeat those same failures, those same downfalls, those same traps that our ancestors, that our family members fell into. So by knowing it, now you know what to do in the future. And by knowing what to do in the future, in the present, now you're being a blessing so that your great, great, great grandchildren can read about what you've done in your family, and they can apply the same thing, and it'll go on and on and on for everyone else. Now, that's the blessing of the Lord. Now, I know that, you know, many of you, you know, you tell me what books you like to read. You've told me what what topics you'd like me to talk about, but it's very important that we as a people begin to understand power and how to obtain it. These people that was in this book right here, they didn't have power. They were slaves. However, it is vitally important that we, you know, pay attention to stuff like that and just, you know, be blessed, be encouraged, and start getting some power. My brothers and sisters, please get some power in your lives. You know, walk with your head up. We need that. Because right now, the lack of having power and influence and finances not in order, families in shambles, that's not going to get us anywhere but be stagnant. And that's not what it's about. You know, and a recent miracle I would like to share with you guys is, and I was telling this to the students that I teach. I teach Sunday school once a month, for those of you who don't know, at my church. And I told the students about a story when I was doing my book signing. back in January 5th, 2013. And leading up to the stage play, I didn't have the money to pay for the books. I had the money to pay for, you know, 20, 30 books. But the way we were promoting it, 5,000 flyers, you know, email blasting, Facebook, Twitter, the whole staff, the team that was on the stage play, it was about 17, 18 of us. They all tweeting, posting, sharing their emails, texting everybody. So I don't know how many people to expect, because this was the time when there was an election going on. So right before, you know, the year started. So we passing out these flyers at the elections, the polls. I mean, since November going up to, you know, January 5th. And I didn't have the books. Now, I'm not a, you know, big fan of Atlanta Housewives. You know, it's not something that I watch every day, but I have watched the show many times. I've learned many things from those ladies. And I love what they're doing. They're very successful. They're very, morally, you know, my thing might be a little challenging, but nobody's perfect. But what I love about that show is that they show you how to actually have a concept in your head, how to get the money together, and how to actually produce a show, produce a fashion show, produce a stage play, you know, have a caller call in. I'm going to go ahead and take this call. Yeah, 305 Dade County. Talk to me, King Kevin Show.
Hello?
Yes. You 305, you're on the King Kevin Show. Speak your mind.
What's up, man?
What's going on? Who I'm speaking with?
This P.
This P?
Yeah, man. You talking about the power of God, right?
Oh, the power of believing in, you know, in God. So tell the callers where you calling from and your name.
Oh, I'm calling from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. My name Pete.
Okay. And you had a question or comment about the topic?
I mean, I just, you know, with me, you know, I just got a comment, you know.
Okay.
I just feel like what I got, you know, I wouldn't be nowhere, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be here now. You know, I have plenty of reasons in the past to give up, you know, different situations, and I can go, you know, I can go down them, but the point I'm making is, man, you know, prayer changes things. God, it's for real, man. Like I said, I've been in so many dark places in my life, you know what I'm saying? And I've been in a dark space, and if it wasn't for God, man, you know, I wouldn't be here now, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be making this phone call. So, you know, I give him the glory, and, you know, to anybody out there, you know, who going through stuff, you know what I'm saying? I always remember that, you know, you ain't the only one going through it, you know what I'm saying? And
mm-hmm.
it's all about, you know, the power of prayer, man. And not just that, you know, you got to believe too, you know what I'm saying? You got to have hope, man, a little faith to get you a long way. So that's from my experiences, man. And take it from me, it ain't been all good. So.
And that's real. And I'm feeling you on that as well. You know, you making a call. I wouldn't even be here, you know, right now.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many times God has just saved me from destruction.
Right.
And sometimes, to be honest with you, there's a point in my life that I feel as if I didn't deserve, you know, the blessings that I was getting. I'm like, you know, it was just so many great things were happening.
Yeah.
You know, so you have like mixed emotions. You know, you might be feeling a little guilty. Because
right.
You survived something that, you know, one of your homies probably got killed for or end up in prison
right.
for. You know what I mean?
Right.
So I definitely feel you on that.
Yeah. So, I mean, yeah. It's funny you should mention that, because I was just in a, it was something that came up like recently. And, you know, it was good for me. You know, it was a blessing. It was something that, you know, that I've been praying for, and when it did come, you know, to fruition or whatnot, that was like one of my first instincts. I don't know, you know, I guess it's just human nature, but sometimes, you know, I'll receive a blessing so beautiful, man, and you know, and I often find myself saying that too, like, man, I don't even deserve this, man. that is, like you said, it's almost like a guilt, you know, but, you know, we all deserve it, man. You know, I just feel like somebody said something a while ago that said, you know, God never leaves us. We always leave God. So that's something to think about, you know. So
that's true. Yeah, you're right about that. You know, and like my pastor always says, and it's funny because a friend of mine said something very similar. He was like, yeah, time flies, but you better make sure God is a pilot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So
I like that one.
Oh, yeah. But see, what my friend has said, he called me yesterday. He was like, yeah, you know, time flies, but you better be the pilot. But I was like, nah, God better be the pilot. Because, right. You know, I want to go wherever God taking me. You know what I mean? Not where right. I want to go, because I could be heading straight to death. You know what I mean? But
straight destruction. I agree, brother.
Exactly. So, you know, I just thank God for everything, man. And that's why I go so hard the way I do with my book, my stage play, speaking engagements, because I want to make sure, even if I don't reach out to every single person in the audience or every single person listening to the show right now around the world, I know somebody's going to receive what I'm saying. It's going to be a blessing to somebody. So there's always at least that one person you got to reach for. And I think that, you know, everything I do, as long as I'm able to inspire one person, and you know, I'm good. You know, I've done my job. You know what I mean? So, but I definitely think we're calling the
bro.
Show.
That's the mind state. That's a good way to look at it. You know, and like I say, man, I just want to tell you, you know, before I leave you, I like what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? I like what you're doing in the community. I've seen you personally come a long way. So, you know, you have a testimony that anyone who knows you personally, even those who don't know you, you know, it is magnificent. And that alone, that would show, that would convince anybody, you know, to get on the right side, you know what I'm saying? Get on the light side, like I like to say, you know, that light. And your light is definitely shining bright, brother. And, you know, I thank you, you know, for what you're doing in the community, you know what I'm saying? Keep pushing, you know, your show, it helps. So, you know, just keep pushing, man, and I like, you know, I like what you're doing, and God is good, man. God bless you.
Amen. Hey, God bless you as well. You know, I appreciate it. That was some touching words, my brother, you know, from king to a king. So I thank you, and you be encouraged, and I'm going to keep pushing. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing, you know, and by the grace of God, man, I'm just thankful, man. I'm thankful for every second. I mean, I'm just thankful for everything. I ain't going to lie to you, man. Somebody, because I done been through so much, it's like, it ain't too much you can do to hurt me. The only way it really hurt me is to hurt somebody I love. Trying to hurt me directly, that ain't going to happen.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, but I thank you for that, man. And, you know, we you know, continue supporting me. And we definitely be in touch, man. God bless you.
God bless. Good night, brother.
Thank you. Good night. Yeah, you know, thank God. You know, Mr. P from Fort Lauderdale called in the show. And those who don't know, I'm in South Florida. You know, and one day I'll be doing a show in Atlanta, Chicago, or in New York, or Houston. I'm actually going to be doing a lot of traveling, by the grace of God, you know, around the country, you know, filming my documentary, The Courage to Believe. So please support that. And I didn't even get a chance to finish, but he just reminded me. P just reminded me by calling in. I didn't finish the testimony. That stage play, I didn't have the money. So one day, you know, I'm driving people home from church, because, you know, I used to drive the church vans. I did that for like 3 years, 3.5 years. I used to drive the church van every Thursday night, you know, and I've learned a lot about that. And believe me, let me stick to the story, because I was about to say something else. So that night, it was a cold night. I do remember that. And, you know, I get back to the church, and there was a woman in a parking lot speaking to another woman. And I happen to know both of these women personally. But one of them, you know, she asked me about the, you know, the stage play and the books. Like, hey, Kevin, how you doing? Is everything all right with the books and everything? And No, she asked about the books. She asked about the stage play. Everything cool with the stage play, your book signing? And I was like, by the grace of God, yes, but whoo! I don't have the money for the books. So she was like, you got the books. Kevin, your show is like it's almost in like 10 days. How long would the books take to get here? And I told her, you know, it can take anywhere from 5 to 7 days. She was like, okay, come to my office tomorrow on your lunch break. Because by the time you get off, I'll be home. Come on your lunch break, and I will buy 100 books. I kid you not, that's exactly how it went down. And 100 books with the shipping, you're talking about a little over, a little under $500. I don't remember the exact amount, but it was, you might as well say she gave me $500. And paid for the express delivery to make sure that was there. And speaking of Atlanta Housewives, you guys remember the first season? I think it's the first, second season. You know, I don't watch the show anymore. But the woman who, I think her name was Charisse, she had a fashion show, and she had, guess what? She had a big fashion show. I'm talking about the who's who of Atlanta was there. Celebrities flew in from out the country to come to this lady's fashion show because the major players of that city was at this party. It's packed house. But she had no clothes ready for the show. So it was a big embarrassment. And back of my mind, and I was speaking against, you know, enemy playing in my head, I was thinking that, wow, I would hate for something like that to happen to me. They have a book signing, not to mention coverage in the newspapers and radio twice that week. Well, you know, the week of. And, you know, all kinds of, you know, invitations sent out by mail as well with the King stamp. When I say the King stamp, you guys know those stamps? I have it up here, so I'm not going to get up. But it's like a stamp they used back in medieval days. They take, you know, the candle and the wax, and they get the candle all hot and wet. And then they put it on the back of the envelope, and then they stamp it. To put the initial or the sign to, so the people would know who they're sending this letter to, that this was officially from the king or queen or whatever prominent, you know, status they had in that society. I put my case stamp on those things. So I got a judge was there. Now, I kid you not, a judge came from the invitation. He was actually my judge from back in the day when I was a hot boy. And I've been telling everybody, especially living on the street, those cowboy days are over with. You can't go around thinking you're going with life, slanging drugs, robbing the community. When I say you're robbing the community, you're robbing the community because, and I used to do it myself. You're just not robbing the community, you're robbing your spirit and your soul, bit by bit. But you're robbing the community because these people are stealing food, they're stealing money from what they're supposed to be buying food for their families, their wife and kids, paying their bills with, take care of themselves, or being productive members of society. Or you can't just think you're going to be out here robbing people. Robbing stores, banks, and money trucks, or you know what I'm saying, other people, houses, home invasions, and thinking that's not going to come back to you. I've been in the robbing game. I've been there with the ski mask. Trust me, I know. I've been wiping bullets and putting on gloves and all that. I've been there. Believe me, as handsome as I look, I've done that. By the grace of God, I did not get caught up in any of that because I stopped. When I realize if I do not stop now, I am going to lose my soul. What is it to gain the whole world and to lose your soul? What is it? Think about it. What is it for a woman to sell her body? What is it by being a stripper dancing on the pole or selling her body in the streets? Gaining all the money in the world, driving Corvettes, Porsches, Fendi, Gucci, all this good stuff, posting all kinds of nice pictures on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. Getting all these likes and followers. What is all of that but to lose your soul completely? When you look in the mirror and you don't know who you're looking at. This isn't what my mother or my father raised me to be. You are a king and a queen. You are royalty. God has so much for us in life. And when I realized that, you know, it's like a light bulb just went out. Like boom. This isn't it. It's better to live under the power of God than to live in the destruction of the evil one. Because believe me, there are evil spirits every day attacking us, whether it's through the internet, social media. I know everybody here experienced someone posting something or or saying something to you on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever the case may be, something that's negative that bothered you. I've been there. Was on TV, the radio, our iPods, our iPads, whatever the case may be, or even in our own neighborhoods, or in school, at work. There are evil spirits every day trying to take us down, trying to steal our joy, trying to steal our light. And that shouldn't be so. That's why we got to continue magnifying God, giving him thanks, just giving him thanks in advance. Even though it look like you ain't got a damn thing in your name. Even look like there's no way you're going to pay that rent. There's no way. There's no way you're going to make that car payment, so they might come get the car now. That's what you're thinking in your head, but what you should do is saying, thank God that payment's coming. I got the money for that payment. Not even for the payment. Thank God that car's paid off. Thank God I'm able to buy someone else a car. So don't pray for having that car paid off. Pay for thanking God for being able to buy other people cars. Because you're bypassing all that little stuff. That's what I mean by thinking like an eagle. That's what I mean by thinking on a larger scale. That's power. Remember, being able to have a concept in your head and to bring it into manifestation, to fruition, that's power. To think it, believe it, and execute the plan of what you believe in God to do for you. But you got to do your part in, one, believing, two, writing down the plan, because you speak in it. You're speaking these dreams, you're speaking these goals, but you gotta have written down so you don't forget any of them. Now I got about 58, 59 goals I read almost every day, sometimes twice. And I do that to remind myself, Kevin, this is what you are going to do. This is what you're here for. Not because I want all this rich and glory and fame just so I can just show out, you know, just so I can have the best pictures to post on the internet. No, richest to me is being married with kids. That's rich right there. That's wealthy right there. But I have all these goals because I'm a big thinker. I'm the Joseph in my family. You know, those of you who don't know who Joseph was, read up in Genesis. Toward the end of Genesis, you read about Joseph. He was the guy that was, you know, raised. You know, he grew up a big dreamer. His brothers and they hated on him. They actually tried to kill him, and they sold him into slavery to Egypt. And he ended up going to being a slave, went to prison for being falsely accused of something. And then from there, he went to prison, and from prison he ended up being a leader of the prison. And from there, he went all the way from the bottom. From prison all the way to being one of the top leaders, top generals, overseers of all Egypt in a time of famine. And if you guys understand what a famine is, I know you guys understand it now because we in a so-called recession. But when you're in a situation like that, money and power, they become consolidated. They become closely knit only to people who are either kissing butt, not even butt kisses don't even get this money or this power. It's people who are well connected. That's what I'm trying to say. People that are well connected are the only ones who benefit in times of recession and famine. So for him to be in that position at a time like that, that just shows you the significance of the story. Now I believe I know I'm the Joseph of my family. Can nobody tell me or make me believe nothing else but that? Because I believe in myself. I believe in empowering my nieces and nephews, my brothers and sisters. I am constantly encouraging them. Even my friends, even my text messages. I text people every morning, either good morning or morning blessings. You know, I might put a little more sauce to it, but I believe in that. You know, because I don't know where I'm going to be. I don't know if I'm going to be alive tomorrow or the next day. I don't know if I'm going to make it through the day. Honestly, I don't know. I'm believing in God I'm going to make it to live 110 years old, but I don't know when he wants me to exit. So while I'm here on earth, I am going to allocate as much power so I can distribute some of that power as well to my constituents, to my community, to the people that God is telling me, look, I want you not to pay this, not to invest this money here, but be a blessing to this individual. Anybody who knows me, you know I want to pay, well, you should know by now, my newsletter. You know I'm going to start, we just started a scholarship from under my mother's name, Rosa Pierre Scholarship for single mothers and fathers that want to go to college. I've been speaking that for maybe a year after my mom died, like back in 2009, 2010, I've been speaking that. And we literally started. I collected money, I'm at Christmas dinner at my house. That's what it's about. It's about speaking those things that you want in life and going after it. And you got to listen to some wisdom as well. You can't just go by what you just, you know, what you believe is right. You know what I mean? You got to listen to some people that know better than you. You know, I wouldn't be here if it weren't for people like who encouraged me, who sponsored me. They know who they are. I'm not even going to go down the list because I forget some. There's some key people in my life that played a pivotal, vital role in helping me move forward. At the times where I didn't even believe in myself. I did not always believe in myself. I can't stress that enough. I did not always see myself as handsome. I didn't always see myself as sexy or attractive. I didn't always see myself as intelligent. But it wasn't until other people who seen that in me pushed me forward. And that's what life is about. We got another caller calling in. Let me take this call. Hey, what's going on? Yeah, the King Kevin Show, number 405. Talk to me.
What's going on, man? How's it going, Bridget?
Hey, blessings, man. Speak your name and where you calling from, my brother?
This is Trevor Gordon calling in from Dallas, Texas.
Oh, man, a big ball in the house. Big Dallas, what's going on, Trevor?
What's going on, brother? What's
man,
going
bless
on?
New Year's. Bless New Year's.
Man, happy New Year's, man. A blessing to everybody, all the listeners and everything.
Thank you.
Across the states, you know. Yeah, man, so how's everything going, bro?
Oh, man, I'm just, I'm balling, man. You know, I've been balling since day one, so.
yeah, big things in 2014, this, you know, grinding, man. Big things. But, yeah, just to share my light, man, look, for everybody listening, man, we, like, you know, whatever you believe in, whatever your desires is, man, go for it. You know what I'm saying? Just go for it, because I know there's a good number of brothers that I know that after their own goals, and I mean, like I say, is in the early stages, but when you know something is blessed by God and it's going to work, you just, you know, you feel comfortable doing it. And so I encourage everybody, man, just follow your heart, follow your dreams, man, and go get it. You know, don't wait around. Go get it, you know, and stay prayerful, and I say peace and prosper everybody, man.
Amen. Go get it.
Yeah. I mean, hopefully, you know, there's minds being sparked or whatnot, you know. I mean, just to believe that they could do it, you know what I'm saying?
Amen.
That's why you got the best name for it, man, you know, the courage to believe. Because it says so much with that statements, man, but it's the truth, you know. And, I mean, the youth need to hear it. Some of our peers need to hear it. But everybody needs to, you know, they need to go after it. And stop, you know, if you don't like your job, you know what I'm saying, do something that you like and make sure that you're doing it well, you know. And the rest will take care of itself.
Amen. Amen. Well, definitely, thanks, Trevor, you know.
Yeah, man.
Speaking those words of encouragement.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, man. And hopefully, man, I'll hear and see from you soon, brother.
Oh, yes. Oh, definitely. You will be seeing me, my brother. Dallas, I can't do this film without touching Dallas, man. It's been one of my dreams to be in Dallas, in Houston, you know, for a long time. So definitely for the courage to believe. And I got to reach out to you, my brother. Get that support out there, man, because things are cooking, literally.
Yeah, man, just shoot. Like I said, you got to connect, man. Just holler at me, man. You know, hopefully we could, you know, we're going to see a lot of progress this year, man.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And without a doubt. And by the way, I spoke to the Urban League today in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Uh-huh.
Okay.
So, you know, we're going to see what we can cook up there. And hopefully they actually do open their doors to me.
Yeah.
I'd love to go out there because I know a lot of them, you know, went through that that tornado storm.
And I don't
know how many are still suffering from what happened out there.
Well, I know definitely, like I said, we're plugging you in over in the south, well, the southwest, Midwest. You know, we definitely plugging you in this area, man. So, you know, like I said, keep doing what you're doing, brother. I mean, like I said, we're going to make it. We're going to make it, bro.
Well, amen, amen. Hey, you might beat me to it, but, hey, if you do, and you know, just don't, you know, reach back to me. And if I end up, you know, making those few meals before you do, I'll be sure to reach back out to you because real recognize real.
We should, as long as somebody making it, man, we all making it.
We all
making it. You know what I'm saying? They're really thorough. Everybody's going to make it, you know what I'm saying?
Amen.
So, like I say, we'll see, you know. But I say peace and blessing to everybody, man. I hope y'all being safe. Be dreamful, you know what I'm saying, and go after it, all right? God bless y'all, man. And, bro, I'll holler at you later on, bro.
All right, then, bro. God bless you.
All right. God bless you, too, brother.
Thank you. One time for home team up there in Texas, Dallas, you know, checking in. You know, saw what happened to the Cowboys, but hey, better luck next year. But thank you all. It's been a blessed night. And don't forget, stay prayed up and believe in all your dreams and goals. And just be a blessing to somebody. If you can't get to where you want to go in life, be a blessing to somebody else. You know what I mean? To help them get there, you know? And see how you can just show more love, you know. Don't live this year so closed in, boxed in, under pressure, you know what I mean? Just show more love, you know. Just try it. You never know. You might just like it. You might just like showing somebody else more love because you're going to see that more love will come back to you. That's how the universe operates. That's how the cosmos operates. You know, you put out there and it comes back to you. You know, you put your blessings out there, it comes back to you. Come back to you in a tsunami. You know, you got so many blessings coming, you don't know what to do with it. That's the kind of problem I want. It's a good problem. God bless y'all. I love y'all. Love, peace, and good food. Check me out, thecurseofbelief.com, and the documentary is coming soon.